Now, the Yankees have a little bit of a decision to make because yesterday, a lot of the writers that are covering the Rays and the Astros series went over to the Yankee complex and spoke to Aaron Hicks. And Hicks said, I'm healthy. I'm ready to go. Do you put him on the roster for the ALCS? Now, I'll give you my opinion very quickly. I think I do. I don't know if I start him because I want Stanton in left. I want Gardner in center. But a switch hitter off the bench, I think I put him on the roster.
Well, especially when you know that if you have a lead late in the game that you're going to replace Giancarlo Stanton.
Yep.
And right now, Maben's fine in left field, but... You know, you could argue that the best defensive outfield the Yankees have is Hicks in center and Gardner sliding over to left, and that gives you a better chance to have coverage in the outfield and gives you a better chance to win the game. We saw it in Minnesota with Hicks made that play that saved a 14-12 game. So, yes, does he give you better defense? Can he throw is the key because his injury was in his throwing arm.
Right. They said he's fine, though.
So as long as he can pass all the tests, then you know, you could make that argument just for defensive purposes and the versatility of having another left-handed bat. Say you get into extra innings, you've already made the defensive alignment changes, Stanton's on the bench. Now, you know, Hicks can give you an at-bat. He, you know, he can walk, too. He's got great, a high on-base percentage. He really works the count. Maybe he gets a big walk, you know, in extra inning somewhere down the road,
well,
too.
Well, let's say you do put Hicks in. And now the question is it Voit that leaves? Is it Tyler Wade that leaves? Now, you really don't have a backup infielder other than Tyler Wade, but he's also a backup outfielder. Is it Maben that leaves? I mean, as much as I like Luke Voit, I think how's Luke Voit going to get any time? Because the Yankees don't pinch hit for anybody. And he's not going to come in for defense.
Well, theoretically, against a left-handed starter, that could change.
But then Aaron Hicks. Well, you think that they would start him against left-handed?
It's possible. It's possible if you had faith in Luke Voit or even as a pinch hitter against a left-handed reliever, you know, that maybe you'd expend that bullet. I think it comes down to whether, you know, how much confidence you have in Gio Urshela. Would you put him on the bench and let Edwin Encarnacion play first and let Voit DH? You know, would you want to preserve that option, I think, is what it comes down to. But it's a legitimate question.
Mm-hmm.
It's either, if you're going to put Hicks on the roster, it's either straight up for Maben or does Voit come into question?
And I think Maben's really helped them. I don't know if you remove Maben. He hit that home run, and I think the team really likes him, and there's something to be said for camaraderie. It's not an easy call.
No, it's definitely not an easy call. You know, Maben helped him during the regular season, and he hit a home run the other night just because he happened to, you know, it was a kind of a throwaway at bat because he had replaced Giancarlo Stanton for defensive purposes.
Right.
So it's really for defense. It's really who do you want playing defense? That's the most important move.
And Hicks is a better defender than Maben.
That's the point. That, you know, it's
you put that, Hicks in center and Gardner in left.
Maben's not on the roster to get a start.
Right. I mean,
he's not on the roster for his bat. He's on the roster to replace Giancarlo, you know, late in the game with a lead.
CeCe looked good in a simulated game. Maybe too late for this series, but if they advance to the World Series, is there still hope we can see Sabathia?
I'd like to see him, you know, in this series for Yordan Alvarez if it's Houston, or even against Austin Meadows. There's a couple of left-handed power bats that I think he could really match up well against. CeCe still has a really good slider. And, you know, to me, you know, his career numbers against lefties are really good. So if I, you know, Yordan Alvarez is a beast. And he's, you know, it's kind of like me in 2000 against Mike Piazza.
Right.
I knew that's why I was on the roster for Mike Piazza. There's numerous examples of one hot hitter. I can go back to 96. Juan Gonzalez, when we played the Texas Rangers, Juan Gonzalez was the MVP that year. The only guy who can get him out was David Weathers late in the game. Mm-hmm. So there's always that one matchup. And for me, if you're matching up against Houston, I'm thinking CeCe Sabathia, start looking at Yordan Alvarez's videos because that's the guy you're going to have to get out.